So for really obvious reasons, we're not going to put this video out until after we get back. But I thought it was really important just to talk about the planning, because I think sometimes when we see these sorts of things, it's all a bit rah, 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 yeah, run an aid mission, let's go. And I suppose that happens early on, you know, the vision to go, let's do this. Everyone gets motivated behind the common purpose. But actually, it's really important to then take your leadership hat off, put your management hat on, and say to yourself, okay, how do we actually make this work, and what's the reality? And our kind of principle of intelligence, not information, is critical here, because it's really important to avoid the echo chamber of what you want to hear and work out what's actually happening and what's real. So this is about our fourth mission now. And over that period of time, probably 4 or 5 months now, we've built up friends, we've built a network of people inside Ukraine. And that's critical for two reasons. Firstly, it means that we understand what they actually need and where we can actually help, which is really important, because that's where our motivation comes from, to know that we've got a unifying purpose and what we're doing is achieving something real, which for me has always been the strongest motivation. And secondly, it means that we're getting real ground truth. So rather than responding to kind of news articles or hearsay, we're working as best we can with intelligence. So what we've then done is we've looked at the risks as much as we possibly can. And I think, as I mentioned in a previous video, we've collaborated with some friends out here that run a risk management company. So we've brought one set of vehicles out. We're going to change the local vehicles when we move towards Ukraine. And that's not actually kind of a spy thing. It's a common sense thing. Those vehicles have the right number plates, the right paperwork, and it just makes the transition across the border much easier. There's a risk, obviously, of air threats. I'm sure you've all seen the news with the drones and the bombings going on. The problem with that is we can't really mitigate against it. It's the right place at the right time. And that's a risk that we've sat down and been really honest with the team about. We've said, look, here's a risk. And the only way you mitigate this particular risk is by actually not going into Ukraine at all. And that has to be a decision for the team. So I've stated my position, but it's then really, really important that the team accept that risk and responsibility for themselves. And we've done that by providing as kind of as much intelligence as we possibly can. And in actual fact, again, we've analysed the risks, and probably the biggest risk to us is a young Ukrainian soldier who's had maybe just a few weeks training, who's frightened and nervous. So actually, by wearing our kind of blue and pink kit, union flags on our arm, making it really obvious that we're here to deliver aid, we again minimise that risk. So it's about filtering out the kind of perception, focusing on the intelligence, and then building a plan around that. And we've got a steady plan to sort of foot post in across the border to one location, test it, see that it's okay, check another location and go again. And we've got people to talk to at every step. Combine that with the fact that we're using a little bit of modern technology to make sure that the people back at home have got kind of regular contact, they can see where we are. Then we can't eliminate the risk, because you eliminate the risk by not going. It's not about manning up, because that's just nonsense. It's about being courageous. So it's about being honest, understanding the risks, sharing those risks with a team, collectively deciding that we're comfortable to accept those risks, and then making a plan to mitigate them as much as possible. And of course, the other thing we've done is kind of actions on. So when it goes wrong, what do we do? And as a team, we've sat down and worked that out. So though, I guess as the kind of leader of the team, it's my responsibility to make sure we've done that, and that it actions. It's very much collaborative or affiliative to get the team together to come up with that plan so that everybody's bought in and comfortable. And for me, I guess this is where the imposter syndrome thing kicks back in, because it's like, you know, wow, these guys are volunteers. They're here on their own time. They're using up their own holiday. And yet still they want to go. And I kind of makes me question myself, but we'll keep at it. So far, so good.